You can achieve mouse-like precision with the controller without aim assist with motion controls. In this guide, you will learn how to set it up both gyro and flick stick on almost every game. This method works on Steam Deck and on PC. Every chapter of this video will have the label essential and optional, so you can jump to the part that you actually need. You will need a controller with a gyro sensor, like the DualShock 4, DualSense, or the Nintendo Switch Pro Controller. Many third-party controllers and accessories also support motion controls. You will also need a Bluetooth or a USB connection to your PC. It is recommended not to use any extra programs to do this connection, like DS for Windows. Just let Steam do all the work. And patience, you have to do a lot of testing. If you're trying to play CSGO, Deathloop, Boomerang X, Fortnite or Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2, you don't have to follow this guide, because these games already have official native support for flick stick and gyro. Unfortunately, every game needs a different configuration. Since gyro will be emulating a mouse, some games don't work well with mixed inputs, which means mouse and controller inputs at the same time. Some will require full keyboard and mouse emulation. Gyro can also emulate the right analog stick, but I don't recommend that because analog sticks have dead zones and you will need to try to counter them to make this work. And the only way to do that is through trial and error. So usually it's better just to emulate keyboard and mouse. In any case, you can set it up and play with a controller. So first things first, enable Big Picture Overlay and calibrate your controller. To enable Big Picture Overlay, go to Steam, Settings, go to In-game and toggle Use the Big Picture Overlay when using a Steam input enable controller from the desktop and hit OK. Now open the Big Picture mode. Here you will press the Home button, go to Settings, go to Controller, and depending on the controller that you're using, toggle Enable Steam input for PlayStation controllers, Switch Pro controllers, and etc. Now, to calibrate your controller, just go to Calibration and Advanced Settings. Here, you scroll down to Gyro Calibration and hit Calibrate. Now, leave the controller on a flat surface, like a table or on the ground, for a couple seconds. I recommend you to not touch the table and to not shake your leg. Auto-calibrate gyro drift when stationary will attempt to calibrate your controller if you leave it still for a couple seconds. To guarantee that this is working properly, hold your controller and try to keep as still as possible. If the bars don't fill up while the controller is in your hands, but they do when sitting still on a flat surface, then you're good to go. I recommend leaving it on. And if that not the case, you can manually set it up with the auto calibration tolerance sliders. In game, press the home button to bring up the Steam menu. Now go to controller settings, and here you can click on edit layout. Here you should see all the normal buttons and inputs of your regular controller. It's like any emulator or custom button bindings found on consoles. But maybe someone already made a configuration with gyro and or flick stick. Now, just go back, and here you can find different community layouts. You just have to click on the configuration you want and press square to apply it. Usually they will have further instructions in the description. If you keep community layouts highlighted, you can import configs made for different controllers by pressing the Show Different Inputs button. The Switch Pro Controller and DualShock 4 have the same values for gyro and flick stick. DualSense is always double of that value. So with that knowledge, you can import pretty much any config you want and just tune them accordingly. Here's a list with a bunch of games optimized for gyro, for the DualShock 4 and DualSense. You can import those configs and make any adjustments you want. It's very likely that you want to change the settings anyway, or make your own for a game that does not have one already. So let's go through every setting. To activate gyro, go to Controller Settings, to Edit Layout, and on the Gyro tab, you set gyro behavior to mouse. As I said before, if your game of choice doesn't allow for mixed inputs, you will need to change every other binding to a key on the keyboard or emulate the right analog stick, which I don't recommend. If gyro behavior is set to mouse, changing the mouse sensitivity in-game will affect gyro. But in games that mixed inputs aren't allowed and gyro is set to joystick move or joystick mouse, the in-game stick sensitivity will influence the gyro sensitivity. Lean left and right binding. Here you can bind actions for when you lean the controller, like when you're playing some games that you can actually lean, like Rainbow Six. You can bind those buttons to the actual act of leaning the controller. Now, click on the gear icon. Here you will find 5 sections. Let's review all of them. General. Sensitivity. Setting a low sensitivity value on Steam can cause stepping. This happens because Steam inputs convert gyro to fake mouse X and Y values. These mouse cursor values are only sent through as whole pixel values, not fractions. So, if this slider is low, you may notice stepping as you use gyro. It's best to try to have a low sensitivity in-game and above 100% on Steam. Ideally, you want to find the natural sensitivity scale, which means that 1 degree in real life is equal to 1 degree in game world. Usually this requires a very low sensitivity in-game, but how do you find the natural sensitivity scale? You will keep the Steam sensitivity at 100%. In-game, you will change the sensitivity until 1 controller rotation in real life equals 1 full camera rotation in-game. After that, you can change the sensitivity on Steam to what you like, and with the same process, you can maintain the same sensitivity in every game. Since some games don't allow such low sensitivities, you may need to set Steam sensitivity a little lower than 100%, depending on the game. If that's the case, just multiply the value for what you want, like one full rotation was 100%, and I like to play with 300%. So now, if one rotation is 93%, for example, I just do 93 times 3, which is 279. Vertical sensitivity scale. If you put it in the middle, the vertical sensitivity will be the same as the horizontal sensitivity. If you put the slider up, vertical sensitivity will be greater than horizontal sensitivity. This setting will come down to personal preference. I like to always increase the vertical sensitivity, so I can easily look all the way up and all the way down, without twisting much of my arm. Acceleration. This is the same as mouse acceleration. The faster you move, the further you go. I usually use a low acceleration or none at all. Movement threshold. Remember what I said about Steam using fake X and Y mouse values for gyro sensitivity? This slider will reduce the resolution of that X and Y value, causing stepping. This is useful in some games that are really sensitive to small movements, so this setting can solve the issue of noisy movement. Output. Invert vertical axis. It does exactly what it says. Pointing up will go down and vice versa. Invert horizontal axis. It does exactly what it says. Pointing right will go left and vice versa. Rotation. This setting seems to be broken because I couldn't find any difference between leaving it all the way up or all the way down, and I'm not really sure what it is supposed to do. Smoothing. It comes down to personal preference. However, if you use too much smoothing, you can lose precision and responsiveness, creating a delay effect. Gyro enable button. You can leave gyro always on or turn gyro only when a button is pressed, or disable gyro when a button is pressed. This will vary from case to case. If you're playing a third-person game like GTA, Monster Hunter, or Resident Evil, you can set the aim button to enable gyro. Button behavior changes the behavior of the gyro enable button. If set to on, the gyro will be enabled only when you press the gyro enable button. If set to off, gyro will be active all the time except when you press the gyro enable button. If set to toggle, the gyro will be toggled when you press the gyro enable button. If you plan to use gyro always on, you must set a button to disable gyro. I will let Solar Light give a better explanation than I ever could.
You know how you can lift a mouse off the mouse pad to recenter it? How would you go about using that on a controller? It's always in your hands. Well, when you lift the mouse from the mouse mat, it pauses the inputs from the mouse until you put it back down. So the logical idea would be to have a button that pauses the gyro aiming while held. For example, I could put it on a face button. Whenever I hold that button, I can move the controller without it messing up my camera, allowing me to reposition it, just like a mouse. This is otherwise known as gyro ratcheting, and while it does feel a bit weird at first, you can become better at it with some practice.
You can do that with gyro enable button, or better yet, with an action layer, but I will get there later. Gyro turning axis. There are 2 modes for gyro, yaw and roll mode. You will change this depending on the way you hold the controller. Do you want to tilt or roll the controller? Usually, yaw is better for playing on the TV, and roll is better for portable play. But that's not a rule. You can also use both at the same time and set how much they will influence each other. Experiment and see what's best for you. Gyro lean point. Change how much of the controller you have to turn in order to activate gyro lean left and right binding. Trigger dampening. Trigger press mouse dampening. Sometimes you press the N button and you want to lower the sensitivity of the gyro. So this option does exactly that. The slider below controls the amount of dampening that will be applied. If you turn it down, you will increase the amount of sensitivity when pressing the trigger press mouse dampening button. But the maximum value is the normal sensitivity. So no matter what you do in the slider, will always be lower than the default sensitivity. Haptics. I think this option only works with the Steam controller or with the Switch Pro controller and controls the amount of vibration on the controller when using gyro. Flickstick. What we want is to calibrate the analog stick to snap the camera to any angle. To activate Flickstick, go to controller settings, then on the joystick tab, change the right joystick behavior to Flickstick. The click action changes the input of the R3 button. With on-click command, you can bind a button to the flick action. Now, click on the gear icon. Here, you will find 5 sections. Let's review all of them. General sensitivity, pixel per resolution. You will need to calibrate this in order to flick stick to work properly. But how do you get this right? Go in game and align the camera with something. With gyro disabled, set snapping to 90 degrees. Put sweep sensitivity scale and sweep tightness and release dampening speed to 0. And set both dead zones to the same value. Now, try to do a 360 by flicking the analog stick 4 times in the same direction. If it overshots, lower the sensitivity. If it doesn't go far enough, increase the sensitivity. After getting a perfect 360 degree, you can put every other setting to the default value and just leave the sensitivity with the new value that we just set up. Sweep sensitivity scale. If you calibrate it correctly, 1x scale will always mean 1-to-1 movement. Meaning that 360 degree analog rotation will perfectly translate to 360 degree in-game rotation. But if you want, you can cut that in half, and now to sweep 360 degree in-game you will need to do 2 full rotations on your analog stick. I recommend you to leave it at 1. Rotation. Sets where the north of your controller is, which means if your initial forward flick sends your camera to anywhere that isn't forward, you can compensate for that with the rotation setting. Output axis changes if the flicks are horizontal or vertical. I haven't played any game where I needed to change this, so I usually just leave it at horizontal. Invert horizontal axis. It does exactly what it says, pointing right will go left and vice versa. Snapping. Make you flick only to set directions. If your snapping mode is set to forward only, the front angle dead zone will be active. This is useful because if you push the analog forward and the camera jitters or flicks a little, you can increase this dead zone to make your forward push better smooth. Speaking of smooth, smoothing. Flick turn tightness controls how long it takes to flick the camera. Increase to immediately snap the camera and decrease to have a slow flick. Default is a good balance between speed and smoothness, but I prefer to slow down just a bit. Sweep tightness filters noise coming from the analog stick. If set too high, sweep could be jittery. If set too low, it will have a delay effect. Default value is a good balance. Release dampening speed. Sometimes you flick and the movement of the analog returning to the center flicks the camera again. This setting fixes this issue. Dead zones. Inner dead zone. The speed of the flick action will be influenced by the inner and outer dead zone. The inner dead zone is responsible to initiate the flick turn. The outer dead zone. If you pass this threshold, you will get the maximum flick turn rate. Command radius. The button binded to the outer ring dead zone will be triggered just after this radius. We are almost done, but there is one key feature that is missing. We need a way to disable gyro to reposition the controller, and we can do that with mode shifting. Mode shifting is one of the most powerful tools at your disposal, because we don't want gyro on all the time. We want to set a button to disable gyro so we can reposition it. And in games with mixed inputs, it may be better to use menus with gyro disabled, for example. So to make use of mode shifting, go to controller settings and go to the action sets tab. Here you can modify your action sets. Action sets changes the entirety of the controller bindings. we are able to change all the settings thus far because we are already on the default action set. But we can create more and change between them in various ways, like pressing or holding a button, or depending if the mouse cursor is shown on the screen or not. We can also add action layers. Action layers are parented to action sets, so instead of changing the whole controller configuration, layers changes only a few buttons. For example, instead of changing all the bindings just to disable gyro, I can create a layer to disable gyro. Now I can bind a button to apply that layer with activators. You can navigate between action layers and action sets with R1 and L1. So I'm on the action layer gyro off, and here I disable gyro. So I gone back to the default action set, I go to joystick, and here I will add an activator. Activators are what make every button work. Every button needs an activator. The default is a regular press, but you can make every button do different things depending on how you press them. You can do a regular press, hold, maybe activate something when you start pressing a button and another thing when you release it. It's up to you. Select the button you want to change the activator on. Click on the gear icon. In the first option, you can change between the types of activators. You can also change many settings here, like how long is a long press, or delaying the start and end of an action, setting if that button will be interrupted by another, and much more. I like to set a long press to R3 to apply the gyro off action layer. So I will create an extra command that will hold the action layer set. I will disable these options because I don't want pop-ups in my screen. I set the layer to gyro off, and I hit confirm. Then I'll set it as a long press, and in the settings I will change the time that is needed to do a long press. Now gyro is active, now it isn't anymore, so I can reposition the controller. That way I can still punch and disable gyro with the same button. I'm able to do two actions with one button because of extra commands and subcommands. Extra commands are extra activators on the same button, and subcommands are bindings that will be triggered at the same time as the activator. For example, in Doom Eternal, the weapon wheel doesn't work properly with gyro on. So in the weapon wheel button, I will add an extra command. I will bind that to the weapon wheel button. Now I will add a subcommand, and I will bind that to the hold action layer. And I will set this activator to a long press. And I will set this long press to be a little shorter. Now, I can hold the weapon wheel button and gyro will be disabled until I release that button and return to the game. If you want further information, I recommend this video from the Steam Controller Fan Club, an in-depth explanation of activators and how to use them. Unfortunately, many times there won't be an elegant solution to enabling gyro in the game and disabling in menus. So I recommend binding a button to change between action sets. Now that you understand all of this, I highly recommend checking Nero's video. He goes into details and techniques that I may not have touched, such as full keyboard and mouse emulation for controllers. You got to the end of the video! Here's a bonus chapter with some good practice for maximum gyro and flickstick enjoyment. As I said before, always prioritize gyro as a mouse. Always disable aim assist to not have a virtual magnet throwing off your aim. Always set a button to disable gyro and recenter your controller. You can also join the gyro subreddit and Discord server and ask for help, hang out, and show off your clips and configurations. If this is your first time, I have a playlist with tips on how to get good with gyro. Shout out to JibSmart for creating Flickstick, to Aubrey Hasselgren? I don't know if I pronounced your name correctly, I'm sorry. He works at Valve and he answered a bunch of my questions. To Aya Lopez for an amazing list of PlayStation gyro configs. And for Sololite for allowing me to use a clip of his video. Social media for all of these people are in the description. For more motion control games and tips, show gyro to your friends! Give me a like, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.